Hi, Mariam, PhD with 20 plus years in AI. I'm showing you my 12 steps, a smart compass framework where we go from scratch to a live cyber defense dashboard. All you need is basic Python. Let's build. So letter S is for setup, a quick environmental prep. Create a virtual environment. It's just a few lines of code. You run it. Then we need to install our requirement, all of our libraries, LangGraph, LangChain, OpenAI, and Gradio. The next step is to do your API key, but also determine your LLM. For us, it's 5 nano, cheapest, fastest, has a lot of tokens, and also is very recent. It's an important step, but just take a few minutes to do. The next letter is M. So the most important thing is to know our mission, our goal. So in this case, we are creating a cyber defense multi-agent system. So multiple agent would be there. It will just get our raw data, will go to a security log, and then AI agent will find actually some threats in that data and will make some incident report. And those reports will give us some action plan. That's actually a little bit our AI cyber defense. And the next letter is A. So now it is necessary to know what's our architecture. We're gonna get an ingest agent, which reads actually security logs and validates data quality. And then we'll pass it to detect agent, which will find threats and anomalies. And then we'll pass it to classify agent, which will assess risk levels and enriches with context. The last one generates incident reports and action plans using AI tools. Because we are working with a graph, every agent is a node. You can see we have a node, which is an agent state. So this is our agent. And inside agent, we give all of the information that are necessary for that agent, including our LLM, our the model tools, and the prompts. Same for detect node, classify node, and for report node. The next letter is R. So how would we add actually reasoning to each of these agents? It's extremely simple because it's pre-built actually in LangGraph. So from this part, LangGraph pre-built, we import create, react, so reason and act. It reason and it decides at the same time. And when you are creating any kind of agent for each of these nodes, the only thing that we need to do is to create React agent and then pass actually our model tools and prompts to it. The next letter is T. We go to the detect agent. What you can see is these are the tools that detect agent use: pattern detector, anomaly detector, and threat lookup. I go to the tools, detection tools. This is a format we use in LangGraph to determine that something is a tool. And after that, you basically write a function. We look at the pattern detector tool, which will actually read up our data. We'll look at the pattern, user, IP, message, and the confidence. The second tool is an anomaly detector tool, which will look at the events, and in this case, kind of find actually the anomalies. Then we have tools, which are the threat lookup. And in this case, we'll look at the risk, so the risk score. As I said, all of that is just process and calculation of the data. The only thing that is really important for you guys is to know that what is the business that you try to do, and when building AI agents, basically add those calculations to the tools. By the way, if you feel lost between tutorials, I made one module of my AI agent mastery training free. It's a deep dive style zero to hero. It includes a valuable free guide. You can check the link in the description. The next letter is C. So the collaboration part of the AI agents in LangGraph is shown by the graph. We will build actually a state graph, which is from this agent state. So, and we add each of the nodes. So we have a graph from all of them, connecting from start to ingest, ingest to detect. And then we will add some conditional edge. If detect has anomalies, we'll go to the classify node. Otherwise, it will go to end. And after that, if classify again conditional and needs a report, if you want actually a report, then it goes to report. Otherwise, it goes to end. Finally, if we go to report, we always after that end our graph. We compile that graph. This is how we determine our collaboration. We can't just leave it to our AI agents because otherwise, they wouldn't know how to collaborate, which one should hands off to another one. Same as in real world. So think about their collaboration and then build a graph based on that collaboration. It's as simple as that. The next letter is O. So now we can run our project. In this way, we say we want an output and also show the reasoning. So if we run that. 5 nano is also reasoning, so it takes a little bit longer. So what we can see is we've got a security incident report, show all of the severity findings. It should just also show the label for that, also for medium and low severity. After that, it will recommend some action, immediate action, urgent action, and general recommendations. And also, there is an agent reasoning, a comprehensive report of 52 findings and 14 recommendations. So the reason that we have 52 findings is that these 26 anomalies can have multiple problems. And agent confidence score. And finally, we have saved a report and we are done with it. The next letter is M. Let me show you how to add memory. It's super, super simple. Building the graph. Adding all of the nodes and edges. Before just compiling it, we can add a checkpointer in memory saver. And then we say checkpointer is checkpointer, the one that we have done. And this memory saver is from LangGraph, as you can see. So let me run it. So this time after running it with memory, we can see that memory status is that 4 steps has been inside that memory and agents with confidence score are 1. So basically we are now adding to the learning, and what it does, it always remembers the information about the previous agent, pass via that state to the next agent and to the next agent. So this was memory. So the next letter is P. So the way that we can present things better is with markdown. Where we have done that is in our run. We have said, can you write a markdown report to an incident report.md? So that's an optional pass as a help and show it. You can see the high severity, 20, medium severity. Then each of these findings has been listed, each of the accounts. After that, some recommended actions, immediate actions. And the way we activate it is when we run our program, we always can say out a report in an MD format, in a markdown format. By introducing something so simple, just adding that report, we make it way easier for our analysts, for our the user of the system to see everything in a very beautiful format. It's also the, say, P from the prompt. The way that we present one specific role to our agent. That's also one of the things that you can do. And you can do it for detect. You can see we have done the same. You're a security threat detection specialist. Analyze security events for threat and anomalies. In the ingest, we will do you're a data ingestion specialist. Parse and validate data. And the report, you're a security analyst. Write a markdown report, group similar findings, include counts, be precise and avoid fluff. So this is also the part that we use both system, user and prompt in our system to actually add a little bit more instructions. The next letter is A. In assessing your output, the most important thing is to take a look at information created by LLM, which is from the point of view of business. For example, LLM comes with 100 foreign logins or a number of credential stuffing or privilege escalation. And about 70 of those are good after analyzing them. That's actually showing the performance is 70%. if 98% of them are correct, and then the performance is 98. So it's based on how much of value has been added to your system. That's really important. The last letter is S. We want actually to build an user interface around our AI cyber defense. And we are going to use a Gradio. Here is the Gradio interface. We can start a block. This is the title. We are having some checkbox. So this is a GR file, GR checkbox, and GR dropdown, and GR slider. So it is extremely simple to just build that. And any of them, you just go to Gradio and ask actually for, okay, what kind of formatting I need to do. Let me run it. You can see AI cyber defense, automated cybersecurity threat detection using AI agents. I can upload the file here, security logs. Then I can add agent reasoning. We can say use nano. We can even go ahead and use 40 mini. Then we don't turn on fast speed because we want our LLM to work, and we say analyze security log. It's unfortunately very, very fast, and you can see detailed incident report, agent reasoning process, AI enhanced report, 6 security threats, events, anomalies detected, then the agent report, how much of confidence it has, detection, the classification, and finally, what kind of models we have used. Building Gradio itself is really easy, and it adds this level of trust and understanding to your AI agents. And here we have it, guys. We have done all of the steps of a smart compass for our AI cybersecurity system. In the next video, I will break down the most common pitfalls. I will show you how to fix them. This is not only teach you how to build AI agents that actually work in the real world. You also learn about other tools and frameworks like Crew AI and Hugging Face. See you there.